Welcome back, everyone, to the Xamarin Show. That's your host, Gerald.
And I have Andrei on today as my guest, and he will talk all about the touch effect. Tune in. Welcome back, everybody, to the Xamarin Show. I'm your host, Gerald, and today we're going to talk all about the Xamarin Community Toolkit. And I have as my special guest, Andrei, who I have been working on from the Community Toolkit, basically from the beginning, because he is one of the core members. Hey, Andrei, how are you doing?
Hello, Gerald. Doing great. How about you?
Great. I'm doing fantastic. Thank you, because I have you on the show. So what else could I wish for? So, Andrei, you've made Microsoft MVP not too long ago. So congratulations on that. It was well-deserved. I think people know you from the wonderful plugins that you've been putting out there. And, you know, that's one of the reasons I think we contacted you to be become a member of the Xamarin Community Toolkit. Of course, we're all members. We can all contribute, but we need a couple of people who, you know, drive the thing. And you're one of them. So what is the plugins that you've been working on?
Yeah, the main plugin, but it's not like a plugin. This is entire library I'm working on. That's, of course, Xamarin Community Toolkit. So
of course,
participating in the development process, some discussions, etc. But I also have several other plugins. For most of them are for Xamarin.Forms, and the most interesting, I guess, that's Cards View. This is like a plugin allowing making some carousel view, cube view, and other animations, etc. So yeah, and a bunch of other plugins as well.
Really cool. I think one of them is also the side menu view. We're probably going to record a episode on that as well, because it's now in the Xamarin Community Toolkit. And today we're going to talk about the touch effect, because that is one of the libraries that you've had also that you brought over to the Xamarin Community Toolkit, right? What does the touch effect do?
So touch effect, this is the effect that allows to forget about tap gesture recognizer and make your like UI more responsive when user touch some layout. It can be everything, stack layout, frame, and everything you want. Any view. You can add some animations, and you can make it responsive, so it will be visible that you touch something, that something is pressed, like button behaves, but you can apply this effect to every view.
Exactly. So basically, in the Xamarin.Forms package, you have like the tap gesture recognizer and a couple of others. But you know, this takes it to the next level. Basically, the touch effect, you can have, I think, a whole bunch of things, a lot of options. Actually, let's just hop over to your screen and let's see a little demo of what it can do.
Yeah, sure. Awesome. I prepared a very small sample showing the advantages of touch effect. First of all, let's observe basic sample with regular tap gesture recognizer. So how we did it before touch effect. So we have a layout where we put labels, box view, and etc. So we can put any view. It can be image or any other complex layout, everything. And we assign a tap gesture recognizer like that. And what we have in our simulator, we can click it and see that the counter increases because, sample view model has a couple of commands. Increase command is called, and the counter increase. Yeah. So the question, does it work, Gerald?
I think it does. I can't, yeah. I'm not next to you, so I can't, you know, really see what it does, but I think it does.
Yeah, it works, but is it ideal? I don't think so, actually. So that is why I decided to develop touch effect. Let's go to another tab, touch effect. Here we see the same layout, stack layout. And it also has label, box view, and it also can has it also can have any views. So, but as you can see, we edit, we first of all, we got rid of the tab gesture recognizer and added a couple of bindable properties. Pressed opacity command from TouchEffect and long press command. And how it looks now when I press it, as you can see, you can see that the UI responds for touches. And also, since we added a long press command, if we press and hold, as you can see, it increases 10 instead of just one, like one click, because long press command did the trick. So let's check what we have in sample view model. Increase by 10 command is called, and yeah, actually it increases by 10 our counter.
This is so cool. So basically by adding these three properties in XAML, you can also do it in code, of course. It will be a little bit more complicated then, but in XAML, I love XAML. You can just add these three lines and suddenly you can play with the opacity. So whenever it's pressed, the opacity goes down to half. You will have the regular tab gesture recognizer basically that will just increase by one because you know that's what we're doing in this command. And you also have the long press command, I think. That is not even in Xamarin Forms, right?
Yeah. That's right, but that's already in Xamarin Community Toolkit because actually I use the stable version 1.1.0, so everyone can try it right away. So yeah, this is the first example, and as you can see, when I press the view, and if I move the finger pointer outside of the view bounds, the view is not pressed. So currently my finger is pressed, but yeah, it like behaves like the button in the application. Also, what we have further, the same layout, but I decided to show a couple of more properties. We have pressed scale, pressed rotation, pressed background color, animation duration, and pulse count. Let's check how it looks like. So when I press it and hold, as you can see, it like pulses and it looks pretty good. Maybe not on this example, but somebody.
It's amazing. Andrei, yeah. You're an amazing designer. This looks fantastic.
Thank you. Yeah, so as you can see, background color is changing during the animation, and also it rotates, scales, and yeah, actually there are a lot of properties. Everyone can check what TouchEffect has. And yeah, basically everyone can use hover animations and I mean, changing, everyone can attach the behavior when the view will change its appearance when the pointer is hovered, but definitely it works on UWP, macOS and Android if pointer is supported, but of course not on simulator. But yeah, hover is supported as well, what is great, I think. And the last example, that's for the lazy people like me. This is native animation. So if you're quite lazy, you can just add native animation and attach the command and you will see that it works. Like it tries
right,
to
because, This native animation, because you know normally you would have a button, and that kind of has on iOS the animation to also do the opacity a little bit and something like that. But now we're using a stack layout, and we want to kind of mimic a button, right? So that is what the native animation is for, so that it will kind of look like it's a button, but actually it's not, right?
Yeah, exactly. So I have an Android emulator here, and let me show how it works on Android. So it replicates, as you can see.
Yeah.
So it will work like a native button, but you can attach this effect to any view. And yeah. So, and the last question, for example, if I decide to go ahead with TouchEffect, but I don't have enough time to remove gestures, or for some reason I want to preserve gestures, and does it mean that I have to remove this XAML or revisit all my code if I do markup and code and remove gestures? And the answer for this question, no, I can just add the animation.
So just to be clear, while you're typing in the top, we can see on the content page, we have that XML namespace XCT. He already imported that. So there's the URL so that we can start using that namespace. And whenever you import it that way, which is a cool trick, then you will have access to all of the controls and the things that are in the Xamarin Community Toolkit. So that's why he could start typing XCT touch effect native animation, because it's implemented as a attached property, right? So you can attach all the touch effect things on elements that don't know about the touch effect. That is kind of the way a attached behavior, attached property works.
Yeah, exactly. And in this case, what we have, so native animation is attached, but tab gesture fires animate the command. That's great.
So with this, you can have, with a couple of lines of code, you can mimic that button, you can mimic a input, you can add animations, or you can use a mix of like the tab gesture recognizers that you already have, but you know, you just want to have that one bit that you want to use from the touch effect. You can just add that and the rest will work as it did before. So that is awesome. Thank you so much, Andrei, for coming on and showing this, and of course, implementing this feature, because we're really thankful for that. And I think a lot of people will find this very helpful. So thank you. And I'm sure that we'll be seeing you for some other features on this show again. I hope you will be willing to do that.
With pleasure.
All right, great. Thank you so much for watching. Please check out the other episodes with James, with me on Channel 9 on YouTube. Leave a comment what you thought about it. Click that like button while you're down there. Maybe the subscribe button too. Who knows? And we'll be seeing you for the next episode.